And we welcome you back. Nicolette, how's it coming over there with the money? She's piecing together that gift I got from U.S. Bank. They shredded the money for some reason. I can't figure it out. Stash, maybe you could help her. You know what? Come on over here for a minute.
I'm not so good with the money stuff.
No. You know what? I've been looking at your mustache. Mm-hmm. I used to have one of those.
Really?
Brings back a lot of mustache memories for me.
Really?
Yeah, those were good times.
Yeah, being handsome, clever, witty, like
absolutely,
yourself.
Yeah. In fact, there was the time Glenn was saying that it's unusual instrument day. I went with my mustache to meet these kids, and they were learning how to play violins with the Suzuki method. And I told them that I also took a different kind of Suzuki class. It's right here in Mustache Memories.
Have you ever attended one of those fancy symphonies and watched and wished that you had the talent to play the classics? Well, the older you get, the more difficult it becomes to learn. That's why the Parkway School District uses the Suzuki method on its children. Instructor Sandra Baker explains.
It's actually a philosophy of education, and Suzuki applied that to teaching young children to play instruments, specifically violin, because they can be made to the smaller size to fit any size child.
This is the Chesterfield Highcroft Ridge Elementary School, where the fourth grade class is learning all the classics.
I like Hoedown and Jingle Bells a lot. I just think it's really fun.
I need a few more scrolls this way. Can you turn a little more this? Ah, that's better. The real focus is on listening and imitating and repeating, and it involves a lot of parent active family involvement with that.
The Suzuki method is also used for other instruments as well, including the piano.
You know, you kids today are probably quite proud of your instruments, as I am of mine. This is a jaw harp. I went to the Suzuki School of Jaw Harping, and I'm very proud of my abilities, and I'm happy that you are allowing me to join you today in this mini concert. I salute you.
Suzuki students at ACE through a curriculum consisting of small steps and leading to the mastery of musical skills. The late Shinichi Suzuki created this method after World War II in his war-ravaged country. And more than a decade later, it was in the United States. And today, many musicians can say they learned to play thanks to Mr. Suzuki.
You want me to play it for you?
Yes.
All right.
But is it possible to play this well after attending only, say, one class? Yes, it is. Before today, I had never before touched a violin. But by using the Suzuki method of overdubbing, even I can play this well.
Bravo!